Good day everyone, welcome to the Fundamentals of Information System videos. And here in this video, we are going to discuss the first chapter or the first lesson entitled Foundations of Information Systems in Business. So in this particular video series, we are using the textbooks as reference guides by James O'Brien and George Markas entitled Management Information Systems and Introduction to Information Systems. Now, why do we need to study information systems? Obviously, sa unang tingin, of course, obvious naman na your course is Bachelor of Science in Information Systems, so kailangan nyo siya talagang pag-aralan. But more than the name of your course, importante na malaman natin kung gaano kahalaga ang information systems and information technology. Okay. In your course, in particular, the difference between computer science, information technology, and information systems is that the information systems course is a product of IT and business. So, on your end, you will notice that marami kayong courses or subjects involving both technology and business as compared to the other two courses that I have mentioned. And besides that, information system is important and the use of information technology is also crucial because what you are catering in the future are the business needs or the business solutions. They are vital to have a successful business. So they are vital component of a successful business. They help businesses expand and compete among others and improve efficiency and effectiveness of business processes. So kung dati, mano-manong ginagawa yung mga bagay, with the aid of information systems and information technology, mas napapadali yung proseso. So imagine ninyo, compare ninyo sa isang fast food chain at isang karinderiya, kung gaano ka efficient at kabilis mag-process ng order sa, let's say, sa McDonald's or sa Jollibee compared sa karinderya na mano-mano kinakalculator, sinusulat kung ano in-order. As compared sa McDo, halimbawa, meron na silang touchscreen to get your orders. So, mas convenient, mas efficient. But of course, it's a case-to-case basis because we cannot always say that the technology or having a high technology in your company or in a business, yun ay ultimate solution. Because apparently, they are just instruments to make business processes easier. Pero hindi lagi siya yung ultimate solution simply because not every business can afford high technology or an expensive software. So again, pinag-uusapan natin yung information systems and information technology as an instrument or a tool to solve specific business problems. But again, they are not the ultimate solutions to all business problems. In information systems, they are vital component of successful businesses. They help businesses expand and compete, improves efficiency and effectiveness of business processes, and facilitates managerial decision-making and work group collaboration. An example of managerial decision-making, halimbawa, in a specific store, halimbawa sa Shopee or sa Lazada, may isang seller doon. Ano ba yung pinakamabenta sa akin? So kung yung pinakamabentang product, madedetect niya using the Shopee or the Lazada application, makikita niya ano yung pinakamabenta na kailangan niyang i-reproduce ng mas madalas as compared to the other products na meron siya. Example ng work group collaboration is here, yung Google Classroom natin. So, our Google Classroom, or I mean the Google Suite, is a work group collaboration kasi yung mga tools ngayon ni Google can cater collaboration among participants, no? So halimbawa, mag-edit ng document, halimbawa mayroon kayong group project, Google Docs, you can actually use Google Docs, no, to share your document, okay, to your group mates at sabay-sabay niyo kayong mag-edit kahit sa magkakaibang page. So sabay-sabay kayong pwedeng mag-revise ng document ninyo. Okay, para makapaghati-hati kayo ng trabaho. So, hindi katulad dati na kailangan isubmit mo sa lahat, And whatever updates you have, isasubmit nyo sa isa't isa. So, yun yung sinasabing collaboration. Another example is the Google Calendar. So, once, halimbawa ako, teacher ninyo, nag-set ako ng, kunyari, yung meeting natin is every Saturday. Okay? So, sa Google Calendar nyo, pwedeng mag-set ako na ganitong dates, meron tayong Google Meet. And with that, nandun na yung link ni Google Meet at magpa-prompt na sa Google Calendar ninyo. So, that makes work group collaboration easier. So, that's an example, again, of information systems and information technology. Now, let's define what a system is. Okay? So, a system, lagi nyo natatandaan, there are four important points as stated on the bullet. So, number one, a system is a set of interrelated components. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya one-man show. Okay? It is composed of different entities, different gadgets, and tools na malalaman natin later on kung ano yung mga components na yon. And they are not independent, they are not dependent, but they are interdependent and interrelated with each other. Kailangan nila yung isa't isa. So, there is no such thing as stand-alone component. Okay, pag sinabi natin system, magkakasama talaga sila. Okay? With a clearly defined boundary. So, hindi siya all-powerful, all-knowing, no? Ang isang system, merong set of scope and limitations. So, ibig sabihin, even the most or the greatest or the most excellent system that we know, meron pa rin siyang particular set of boundaries. So, halimbawa, pag sinabi natin enrollment system, ang ina-accept niya lang is the registration of students, choosing of subjects, okay? And sa ibang schools, kasi sa atin libre ang tuition fee, payment of tuition fees. Pero iba, pag sinabing mag-encode na si teacher ng mga grades ng mga estudyante, so it's another system. It's called a grading system. So, hindi na siya pasok sa enrollment system. But they can be connected. Pero there are two different systems. So, yun yung sinasabi with clearly defined boundaries because next SEM or next year as you proceed with the second year, your second year of college, malalaman ninyo, no, pag magde-design and magde-develop na kayo ng system, masyadong malaki kapag hindi nyo alam yung scope and limitation. So, dapat ang magandang system daw has a clearly defined boundary. Okay? So, may scope and may limitation. And the components must be working together. Again, walang one-man show, walang independent component. So, lahat nagtutugma-tugma or you're working together to achieve a common set of objectives or goals. And that is to have a successful business transaction. Whatever business process or system yung inyong i-develop. Okay, pag sinabi naman nating information system, so it is an organized combination, ito na yung mga components. People, hardware, software, communication networks, data resources, policies and procedures. So ito yung sinasabi dito sa previous slide natin na interrelated components. So ano yung mga components na yon? People, of course, a system cannot work without people. Kahit ang pinaka-high-tech or pinaka-matalinong robot cannot work without humans. Okay? Hanggang ngayon, wala namang ganong robot. Okay, of course, you need hardware and software. Pag sinabi nating hardware, these are the fixed gadgets. Okay? Computer, phone, laptop, tablet. Okay? In our case, sa information system. Or even machines, no? Na nakikita natin. Okay? And of course, software, these are the programs, the computer programs that we operate on sa mga hardware devices. Of course, we need communication networks. Okay, sa panahon ngayon, bihira na ang stand-alone system or hindi kailangan gumamit ng networks. In one way or another, we will be needing internet. Okay, we need network connections so that we can let the system work properly. Data resources, kailangan ng sets of data na pinaprocess. Okay? So, hindi pwedeng point blank or blanco yung data. Hindi tatakbo ang isang sistema kung wala namang ipaprocess. Kaya, papasok doon yung data. At pag pinaprocess yung data, that data becomes information. And of course, there are rules to be followed. Okay? There are policies and procedures to abide by para hindi rin magkaroon ng chaotic system. Because kapag walang rules na inimplement, pwedeng ma-violate either karapatang pantao or human rights. Let's say for example, data privacy law. Okay? So kung ang halimbawa, yung student number nyo is a sensitive data, your birthday is a sensitive data, pag halimbawa dun sa election system, election registration system ni COMELEC, di ba napabalita, may leak, nagkaroon na naman ng leakage, na compromise na naman yung data. So, no yun na mag-leak yung personal information natin. Likewise, yung mga nahack na mga credit cards or mga nahack na banks. Diba? So, there are solid policies and procedures to be followed to make sure that the data na in-entrust sa atin ng mga clients natin will be secured. Okay? This system involves storage, yung pagtatago, retrieves, transforms and disseminates information in the entire organization. Okay? So, yun ang ibig sabihin ng information system. An organized combination of the following components you see on screen that are capable of restoring, retrieving, transforming, and disseminating information in an organization. Now, pag sinabi natin information technologies, these are the components and resources necessary to deliver information and functions to the organization. And pag sinabi natin IT, it can still be paper-based. Okay? Example, photocopy machine. Okay? Yes, may machine, pero print out pa rin yung paper. Unlike ngayon, yung mga dinidevelop na technologies or processes, as much as possible, ginagawang paperless. Okay? But, paper prints or printed copies are still in demand today for backup reasons. So, halimbawa, nahack yung system o yung computer nagloko, at least you have a backup record printed on paper. Okay? Information technologies can include hardware, software, networking, and data management. But in this particular lesson or sa buong semester, our focus is on the computer-based information, okay, or the CBIS. Okay, dahil ang pag-aaralan natin is how would information systems and information technology be a tool or an instrument to solve business problems. Okay, what should you as future professionals know about information systems? So, ito yung mga main branches niya. So, first, na-mention na natin yung information technologies. Na we also have mentioned the foundation concepts, kung ano yung diniscuss natin kanina, like what is a system, what is an information system. And then of course, during your journey or your stay here sa course ninyo sa BSIS, you will be able to come up with development processes. Okay? So, magdi-discuss lang tayo ng theories dito. But your other subjects, like yung programming subject ninyo, will cater for sure yung development processes and even yung database and web development subjects ninyo in the future. We also have the business applications and of course the management challenges. Okay, so hindi lahat ng high-tech dapat kinakagat. So dapat merong check and balance. Okay, so say for example, do you think a sari-sari store can sustain a standalone software or yung so ambawa magpo-propose kayo ng computerized sales and inventory system ng sari-sari store? Yes, it's a good idea. Mapapadali yung tindera mag-process ng kanyang mga nabenta. Okay? But the downside is babalik ba sa kanila yung investment considering na magkano lang ba ang kinikita ng sari-sari store? Okay, baka malugi sila eventually kapag ka nag-adapt sila ng ganito ka high-end na system. So, yun yung sinasabi ko na technology is not always the solution. But it is a tool. It can be a tool. Okay? Now, the fundamental roles of information system in businesses, ang baseline niya is a support. Kaya sinasabi ko, it is not an ultimate solution. Okay? It is only a support for business processes and operations. Okay, so mapapansin nyo, may human intervention pa din. Hindi siya robot or AI at all times. There are instances, pero not all. And then, so yun yung baseline, no? Pag matibay na yung support for business processes and operations, nakakatulong yun to support business decision making. Kasi pag napaprocess yung data, as I mentioned earlier, halimbawa, a seller, no, paano niya malalaman kung ano yung mabenta at saka hindi? Ano yung titigil niyang product? Ano yung seasonal na product? Okay, take the case of the fast food chains in the Philippines. Bakit ang Filet-O-Fish tsaka yung tuna sandwich mas maraming, mas pinopromote kapag March or April or even February? Okay? Because of our culture here in the Philippines, di ba? So, nagkakaroon ng decision making, kaya mabenta yung Filet-O-Fish tsaka yung tuna sandwich kapag February to April kasi dun tumatapat yung Holy Week. And we all know, culturally speaking, majority of the Filipinos, kapag Lenten season, iniiwasan nila yung red meat, yung baka, yung baboy, yung chicken, or yun, pinitira nila fish. Kaya mas mabenta yung fish. Kaya, kung mapapansin ninyo, McDonald's, and Tropical Hot, and even Jollibee, yung mga fish burgers nila, nilalabas nila pag malapit na yung Holy Week. Okay? Tapos yung mga festive naman na products, nilalagay nila sa Christmas. Okay? So, dahil mas maraming pera ang tao nun because of the our law na may 13th month pay, some companies offer Christmas bonus bukod pa dun sa 13th month pay. So, nagkakaroon ng business decision making. This is how to do it. Okay? And paano nila nalalaman yun? Dun sa sales, because of the business operations gathered using IS and IT. Okay? And kapag nasuportahan na or solid na yung business decision making, nagkakaroon sila ngayon ng room to support strategies for competitive advantage. Ano yung magiging lamang na company A laban sa ibang companies? Okay? And IS and IT plays the crucial role as well. So, pag sinabi kong IS, Information Systems, IT, Information Technology. Okay, para lang malinaw. This is the history how information system started. Noong 1950s, nagkaroon ng data processing. So, ano pa lang yan? Sulat kamay or typewriter. Di ba yung mga ledger, accounting books, accounting ledgers. Yun, lahat sulat kamay. Tapos, tinatago sa filing cabinet. And as you progress, no, sa panahon ngayon, everything is, almost everything is computerized. Okay? Kasi mas madali, mas efficient, and at some point, mas cost-effective. So, just walk through this. Available naman tong figure na to dun sa ating module. Now, hapyawan ko lang yung e-business. Okay, it's the use of internet technologies to run a business. But we have a separate lesson for this one. Kung hindi ako nagkakamali, it's in lesson 5. So, hindi ko na siya itatouch muna ngayon. Okay, so we'll skip this one. Okay, types of information system. So, first is the operation support system. Ito yung mga ginagamit ng mga different industries to process business transaction. So, crucial for business operation. Okay, example niyan, yung sa sales and inventory, 'di ba? Yung imbis na ika-calculator at isusulat sa papel yung in order, meron na tayong applications, meron na tayong software na pwedeng doon na i-encode yung order, automatic na nagko-compute kung magkano yung binayad, magkano yung sukli. Okay? Other examples would be, halimbawa, sa factory, yung mga machines na high-tech. Okay, they are triggered kung paano sila nagpa-power on. Yes, may switch. Yes, may tao. Pero kung paano nagsusunod-sunod yung proseso, may gamit si information systems doon. Okay? Of course, we have the management support systems that ginagawa naman niya is to generate reports. Example niyan, yung resibo, yung grade slip, yung summary of grades. Ano pa ba yung mga na-encounter nyo? Transcript of records. So, makagraduate ka ba or hindi? So, paano malalaman? E di yung sa report mo, sa grade slip mo, sa summary of grades mo, kung may bagsak ka pang naiwan, hindi ka gagraduate. So, that's an example of management support system. So, I'm using these examples para mas maintindihan ninyo. Okay? Mas makarelate kayo. Okay? Purposes of information system. So, ito lang yung different types. So, I'll leave this to you. Okay, so operation support systems, ano ba yung ginagawa nila? So, efficiently process business transactions. They control industrial processes. Example niyan, halimbawa, di ba sa mall, before you enter, meron tayong QR code na yung mga, halimbawa, Pasig Pass, Antipolo Pass, yung Stay Safe QR code. So, yan, example yan ng operation support system. So, sinusuportahan nila yung ano, yung operations ng pagpasok sa mall to make sure na walang nilalagnat o may symptoms ng COVID-19 na makapasok sa establishment. So, that's an example of an operation support system. Okay? Saan galing yung QR code? Sa information system. Dahil kinukuha nun, di ba, meron kayong information na in-encode doon, yung pangalan ninyo, sa kayo nakatira, para kapag ka, halimbawa may tinamaan ng COVID-19 nung nasa mall, pwede kayong kontakin para mag-isolate or magpa-test din kung meron kayong symptoms. Okay? So, yun yung example ng OSS. Okay, there are different types of OSS, transaction processing system. Example nga niyan, pag umorder kayo sa fast food, yung pinipindot ng cashier, that's sales processing system, and automatic nakaduktong siya sa inventory system. Halimbawa, bumili ka ng chicken. Okay, automatic sa inventory nila, nabawasan na sila ng isang chicken. Okay, that's transaction processing. Enrollment, yung nag-online, nag-submit kayo ng online enrollment form, that's transaction processing system. Nagbayad kayo ng kuryente, ng tubig, transaction processing system. Process control system, ayan, using sensors. Example, yung sa mga mall, yung touchless na yung pag sa alcohol. So, that's process control system. Okay, and also we have enterprise collaboration system, katulad ng pag-Google Meet. And yung Google Classroom. Those are examples of enterprise collaboration. Of course, pag sinabi natin enterprise, hindi lang siya limited dun sa profit organization. Pwede rin non-profit, katulad ng school natin, okay, or even the government transactions. There are two ways to process transactions. Una, batch processing. Example niyan yung sa check. Bawa nag-deposit kayo ng check, ma-encash nilang siya dun sa account ninyo or magiging mawi-withdraw nyo lang siya. Halimbawa, no, nag-deposit ako ng check tomorrow, Monday. Okay? So, the next day ko pa makukuha yung money sa ATM ko. Bakit? Because they do batch processing. So, what they do, iniipon muna nila. Halimbawa, Monday, bukas, no? So, yan. Fina-file nila yung lahat ng check. Ipa-process nila yon ng gabi. And ma-approve yon the next day. So, yun yung tinatawag na batch processing. Pag online processing, yan yung immediate. Okay? Halimbawa, nag-withdraw ka ng pera sa ATM. That's immediate. So, that's online processing. Or nag-transfer ka ng, nagbayad ka ng bills online. Online processing. Another example of batch processing, yung enrollment ninyo. Okay? Online processing yung tawag dun sa pag-fill out nyo ng form. Pero batch processing yung ginawa sa inyo. Kaya sabay-sabay kayo nakareceive ng COR. Sabay-sabay kayo halos nalaman kung anong section ninyo kasi by batch siyang ginagawa. Okay, management support system. What do they do? They provide information and support for effective decision making by managers. So na mention ko na yan kanina, examples. Which products and services yung magsistay, ano yung seasonal, ano yung dapat tanggalin, ano yung dapat palitan. So based sa information, yun yung magiging basis, one of the crucial factors kung bakit sila magdi-decision ng ganung bagay. Okay? Say for example, yung number of enrollees natin. Okay, so depende yun sa dami, kung depende sa dami, kaya tayo magsisettle kung ilan na yung sections na gagawin. Okay? So, types of management support systems, example, is the MIS. Ito yung most common. Management information systems, example, yung mga daily sales report or enrollment report. Ilan ba yung nag-enroll sa first year, sa second year, sa third year, sa fourth year? Alin ng BSI, ilan ng BSIS, ilan ng BS Entrep, ilan yung sa education. Okay, so yun, management information systems yun. And from there, pwedeng gamitin yun for decision support system. Marami sa BSIS. So, kailangan mas maraming section sa BSIS na course as compared to the others. So, that's a decision support system. Another example nung decision support system is yung yung teleconsultation sa medicine. So, halimbawa, may mga symptoms kang ganito. Okay? And then, the machine o yung computer-based na information system ng hospital, pwede siyang magbigay ng diagnosis or possible diagnosis ng sakit mo. Pero ultimately, may doctor pa rin titingin. Pero the good thing about here is hindi na time-consuming masyado for the doctor to check on you because meron ng machine na initially nag-check up for you. Okay? Executive Information System, ito yung ginagamit ng mga may-ari, mga CEO, mga Board of Trustees, in deciding. Okay? It's the same with management information systems. It's just that yung mga critical decision making kasi, may mga middle management na hindi nasa kanila yung power to decide. Nasa higher ups na. Okay? Kaya, meron din tayong EIS. Okay? Marami pang klase ng information system like expert systems, knowledge management system. Halimbawa, gumawa ka ng template. Okay, pag ginamit na yun ng company nyo all throughout, then it's considered as an information system. It's already knowledge-based. Okay? Strategic information system. So, halimbawa, yung ginagawa ng mga e-commerce sites like Shopee and Lazada, okay, may shipment tracking, di ba malalaman nyo kung nasa na yung parcel na pinapadeliver ninyo or yung in-order ninyo kung nasaan na. Kung nasa delivery center pa ba, kinuha na ng delivery rider. Okay, minsan may automatic nagtitext pa, di ba? Shopee Surprise or Lazada shipping coming within the day. So, yun, that's an SIS. And the functional business system. So, katulad ng mga accounting systems na alam natin, of course, there should be a human intervention pa din. Ando pa rin yung accountant to do the work. Pero ang kagandahan nun, may malaking tulong na coming from the system. Okay, hindi na mano-manong gagawin ni accountant. Okay, IT challenges and opportunities, i-discuss natin to towards lesson 7 or 8. So, I'll skip with this one muna. And then, measuring IT success. Kanina ko pa sinasabing word na efficiency and effectiveness. Ano yung kaibahan ng dalawa? Pag sinabing efficiency, sulit. Ibig sabihin na effectiveness, mabisa. Okay? Efficiency minimizes cost, time, and use of information. Effectiveness means it's working. Okay? It's working properly. So, efficiency is working properly plus other important benefits like nakatipid sa time, sa money, and sa mga resources. Okay? Developing IS solutions. So, kung mapapansin niyo yung steps, it's very similar, almost identical with the scientific way of solving a problem. Yung scientific method na napag-aralan natin sa science when we were in grade school. Diba? You investigate, you analyze, and then you design the software, then you implement and test, and the maintain. Kung may problems, investigate ulit. What's the problem? So, may version 2 na ng software. Iikot ng iikot lang yan. So, the same thing that you're going to do eventually when you start doing your systems analysis hanggang mag-capstone project kayo when you reach fourth year college bago kayo gumraduate. Challenges and ethics of IT, we will study it towards the end. So, I'll skip with this one para hindi naman ma-preempt. Ethical responsibilities, i-discuss din natin next towards the end of the semester. IT careers, so ano-ano yung mga careers na naghihintay sa inyo. So, you have different positions that you can choose. Okay, depende sa inyong mapapasok. So, of course, availability ng job and yung inyong magiging expertise. But basically, sa information systems, more on data and business solutions yung sa inyo. Pero, ayan, yung mga choices na pwede nyo. And of course, dagdag ko lang, yung wala dyan, of course, you can also teach. Okay? Katulad ko. Okay? Na instead of working sa isang IT company, mas pinili ko magturo kasi this is my passion. So, it's really up to you. It's really a matter of calling. Okay? So, yun. Dinagdag ko lang kasi wala dyan dun sa list. IT career, so not so much on that. Okay, IS function. The information system function is a major functional area of business. Okay, so hindi siya main, pero hindi rin siya side job. It's one of the major factors to a successful business. So, kailangan strong, reliable, and powerful ang inyong information system sa isang organization. Okay, it is an important contributor or may malaking ambag sa efficiency, sa employee productivity, tama naman. Kasi kung mano-mano mo ginagawa lahat, pagod ka na, hindi mo patapos yung isang set ng documents. It helps boost the morale of the organization. And of course, pag bumibilis ang service at delivery ng products and transaction, satisfied din yung customers. And that means profit for the organization. Okay? An IS or information system is a major source of information and support for decision making. It is a vital ingredient in developing competitive products and services in the global marketplace. So, halimbawa, nagpa-survey kayo, anong product tingin nyong in? Okay, usually ginagawa ng mga companies yan. And sino nagpa-process ng mga sagot sa survey? It's the information systems. Okay, a dynamic and challenging career opportunity and a key component of today's network business. Totoo yan. Kaya one of the most in-demand courses or graduates are yung nasa information technology, computer science, and information systems. So, mag-aral kayo mabuti. Okay. System concepts, a foundation. So, system concepts help us understand the technology. So, pag-aaralan din natin yan. But of course, I'll skip on the hardware and the software part since you already discussed that last SEM sa introduction to computing. You have the different application software that you can use to apply in a system. Kaya nga siya application. Okay, development. Okay, you will learn different ways to use IT or information technology to produce business solutions. But of course, not only in this subject. Okay, lahat ng subject natin dito since first year kayo is pahapyaw. Okay, you will learn that in your other subjects pa. Okay, and of course, management. Okay, so let's just review. A system is a set of interrelated components with clearly defined boundaries working together to achieve common set of objectives. So meron ng dalawang dumagdag. Pagdating sa information system, they are accepting inputs and producing outputs. Okay? Meron kang enrollment form na in-input, meron kang certificate of registration as an output. Si professor nag-encode, nag-input ng grades, ang output, meron kang grade slip. Okay? Si cashier, in-input yung order mo, output, meron kang resibo. At si McDonald's or si Jollibee or any fast food chain, meron silang sales report. Okay? And a system is an organized transformation process. Okay? So, again, organize siya. Hindi siya chaotic. Hindi siya gulo-gulo. Okay? That's your role as part of the system. So, basic functions of a system. So, we have input, process, output. So, pag sinabi natin input, processing, okay, and output, pag sinabi natin itong mga functions na to, ito yung mga nakikita natin or ito yung magiging process flow or sorry, ito yung magiging workflow ng isang system. So, meron kang input. Pag sinabi natin input, lahat ng ine-encode mo sa loob. Nag-type ka sa keyboard, nag-click ka sa mouse, nag-record ka ng audio, nag-record ka ng TikTok. Those are inputs. Okay, tapos pinaprocess siya ng system para maging output. So, nag-record ka ng video, may lumabas kang TikTok video, may pinindot mo yung letter A sa keyboard, may lumabas na yung letter A sa Microsoft Word. Okay? So, lakihan natin. Nag-input ka ng order mo sa touchscreen, may ako ang output na resibo sa cashier. Okay? And many others. So, bukod dyan sa tatlo, dati kasi yan lang yung basic functions eh. Meron nang dumagdag somehow. Okay? So, meron tayong data and of course, meron tayong network. Okay? So, huwag yung kalimutan yun, ha? So, meron tayong input, process, output, data, and network. Cybernetic system, pag-aaralan natin yan in the future. Okay, business as a system, meron tayong e-business, so didiscuss natin yon. Other system characteristics. So, ang system, kapag ka sobrang laki, meron tayong tinatawag na parts niya. So, the small component, tinatawag nating subsystem. Pag larger system naman, ang tawag natin ay environment. Example, Facebook. So, sa Facebook, meron kang environment. Yung buong account mo is sa Facebook, your Facebook account environment. Yung wall feeds mo, news feeds mo, pictures na in-upload mo. Pero halimbawa, titingin ka lang lahat ng profile pics mo. 'Di ba? Pwede mong i-select 'yun, 'di ba? Gusto mo lang i-check yung mga messages mo sa Messenger. So, yung mga parts, smaller parts na 'yon, those are subsystems. Okay? Forming a larger system called the environment. Now, another term we see here is the interface. Pag sinabi nating interface, this refers to the facade of your computer program. Okay? Any applications, facade. Ibig sabihin facade yung what you see on screen. So, sa Facebook, makikita mo yung blue and white with yung Facebook logo. You have the yung text box for your username and password. Diba? So, what you see on screen, that's your interface. So, hindi lang siya limited sa computer. What you see on your phone, okay, what you see in Microsoft Word, Excel, what you see on the internet, what you see on screen is the interface. Okay? So, importante din yun sa inyo. Why? Because as you develop information systems in the future, dapat user-friendly din yung interface ninyo. And our systems can be divided, or not really divided, but our systems natin dito must be open and adaptive. Kasi pag close yung system mo, ibig sabihin sobrang perfect niya, hindi na siya pwedeng i-improve. At pag hindi siya adaptive, wala na siyang chance to grow and to expand. So, a good system must be open and adaptive. Okay, so you have the components of an IS, na-discuss na natin yan kanina. You have people, hardware, software, network, and data. Okay, so I'll skip with this one kasi na discuss ko na kanina. Now, ano yung difference ng data and information? Actually, nagbigay na ako ng clue kanina. When we say data, we refer to raw facts about physical phenomena or business transaction. Once we process the data into a meaningful way na may recall na sa atin as users, that becomes an information. Example, pag sinabi ko sa inyong dahon, syempre hindi nagpa-process sa inyo. Pero you know for a fact na meron talagang dahon or leaf or leaves. Diba? Okay. So, that's what we call data. Pero pag may recall na sa inyo or na-process na sa mind ninyo, yung dahon na sinasabi mo ay yung lagundi kasi na-discover siya na pwede siya, possible siyang maging gamot sa COVID-19. So, yung utak mo ngayon, from data na dahon, nagbigay ka ng klase, which is lagundi, tapos naisip mo yung, naalala mo yung balitang nabasa mo or napanood mo, na-process sa utak. That becomes an information. Because remember, ang inspiration ng computers ay human brains, di ba? So, halimbawa, sinabi sa'yo 20 pesos. Siyempre, walang dating sa'yo yun. Pero pag sinabing ang pau yun sa'yo dahil Chinese New Year, binigyan ka regalo, yun yung regalo sa akin. So, that becomes information. So, pinaprocess. Pag data, raw facts. Okay? Wala pang sense at all. You know na merong ganong bagay, merong ganong pangyayari, but wala pa siyang impact because hindi mo pa siya napaprocess. Once you process that, it becomes information. Sabi nga dito, when converted yung data, it becomes meaningful and useful sa context ng end users. Example, uno, sa context ni OCC. Uno, raw fact. Okay? Pag pinrasis mo at nilagay mo sa grade slip ang uno, syempre, tuwan-tuwa ang mga estudyante. Bakit? Because flat one means a very excellent grade. Diba? So, ganun, yung data mo na one, it becomes information, useful and meaningful sa context ng students, which is yung end user natin, because we all know na highest grade na you can get is uno. pag raw fact naman yung 5, in-encode sa grade slip, pinrasis at ginagin information, syempre, malulungkot ka because that means you failed. Diba? Pero kung yung raw fact na yun, let's say, 1, nilagay mo halimbawa sa ibang school, hey, for example, Ateneo or Lasal, that means pasang-awa. So, hindi masyadong happy yun. Okay? Kasi 1 sa kanila, in their context, so data, diba? Pinrasis, nag-information. Sa context ng Lasal and Ateneo, ang 1 is pasang-awa or yung borderline na passing grade, 4 yung highest sa kanila. Okay? So, iba naman yung context nun. So, nagigets nyo yung data is a raw fact. Alam nyo yung merong ganun, existing yun. Pero once na na-realize nyo na kung ano yung ibig sabihin niya, syempre sa human brain, that becomes information. Sa computer naman, pag pinrasis yung data, ganun din ang nangyayari. It becomes information. Okay, IS activity. So, meron tayo input, process, output, and then you store. That's why you save it either sa hard drive or sa cloud. Okay, and we have control. So, may monitoring and feedback ka kung working properly yung system. Pag hindi, that's why you have revisions and kaya nagkakaroon ng mga versions or higher versions yung mga software applications natin. Diba? Kaya diba mayroon ding software maintenance, minsan nag-shutdown or for a while nagsha-shutdown po yung mga applications kasi nagme-maintain sila ng system. Okay, recognizing IS or information system. Business professionals should be able to look at information system and identify, of course, the components as I've mentioned, people, hardware, software, data, and network resources, and the type of information they will produce. So, eventually kayo, as you propose your system sa inyong mga future subjects like enrollment, sales and inventory, online ordering system. Okay, so kailangan may identify niyo yung mga yan. Okay? And that ends our module 1. Thank you very much for listening and stay tuned for our module number 2. God bless.